base your diet on plenty of foods rich in carbohydrates. Now this author I am speaking is more for a healthy normal priest. For priests with certain illnesses, there will be other diets that will have to be considered and other things. Replace saturated with unsaturated fat. Enjoy plenty of fruits and vegetables. Reduce salt and sugar intake. Eat regularly. Control the portion size. Drink plenty of fluids. Maintain a healthy body weight. Get on the move. Start now. Keep changing gradually. These are the 10 tips which I will elaborate slightly. On the face of it, all this looks to be but many a times, though it is something very simple, very elementary, we do not do it, and that's why we fall in trouble. Now, eating variety of foods, the first point. We need about 40 essential nutrients for our body to function properly. So we need a variety of foods. We can't just have one or two types of foods and remain on that. And we have to eat the right amount of calories. Many of young, middle-aged individuals who are very active, going up, down, being this, being that, so you need that adequate calories. Normally, a healthy adult would require about 2,500 calories per day, so that we have the right energy to continue with your normal work. And you need to have a balanced diet. Now, second point is base your diet on plenty of food rich in carbohydrates. Now, what is carbohydrates? Carbohydrates is things like rice, pasta, bread, all this is carbohydrates. The glucose, sugar, you know that whenever you are running, playing, people have glucose, people have energy drinks which contain carbohydrates. Because carbohydrates are the energy blocks of the body. Many people will say, what doctor is saying, eat rice, eat carbohydrates, I put on weight. But you have to have the carbohydrates in the right amount to give you the right calories. You cannot just have a big mountain of rice in the afternoon and night and say, I'm having a lot of carbohydrates. So it's not just eat carbohydrates, I get a lot of energy and I will run a lot. No, that's not the way it is. And carbohydrates compared to fats are less caloric. Fats eaten in small amounts will give more calories than carbohydrates eaten in more amounts. So eating carbohydrates in the right amount is very important. Like having rice in the afternoon and say bread or chapati at night, that would give you a good amount of carbohydrates. And now you get whole grain bread, you get whole grain pastas. So these whole grain things contain a lot of fiber. And even the rice that we talk about, it is best to eat our traditional Goan rice, the red rice, not the refined rice, because refined rice is pure starch. That would increase your blood sugar very high. Whereas the rice that we normally have been eating for ages, our forefathers have been eating for ages, our ukde shit, what we say, ukde tandu, is the right one because it contains fiber, it contains vitamins, which over the years many of us have lost because we prefer to eat the refined rice. But medically and even for sicknesses like diabetes, the fat rice, what we call the ukde rice, what we say, is the best rice. So that type of carbohydrates which contain fibers is very important for our good health. Don't replace this type of carbohydrates with the carbohydrates that contain fat. Like people will say, potatoes with carbohydrates, fine. And people eat chips. They eat chips of all sorts. But remember, when the chips are made, they absorb a lot of oil. which is very highly caloric and bad. Similarly, salt is good for the chips. That also will add to many sicknesses like hypertension and other sicknesses. So, carbohydrates in the traditional form is important. And another thing, all you are the great messiahs who can help our people to realize there are traditional foods. Our Gurshis, or Tanwaji Bakri, and all these things like Nashmete, these are real good foods. And not the fast foods that we're eating. We try a lot. I myself as a doctor, plus being involved in training children in football in villages, we make it a point to tell the parents to give the children this type of traditional foods, which is slowly losing touch in Goa today. And because of that, we can see more illnesses are coming at younger age. We find younger individuals getting cholesterol, blood pressure, and diabetes. And I think this traditional foods would be one way to see that this type of illnesses do not scourge our population. The third point, replacing saturated fats with unsaturated fats. It is not that fats are bad or oils are bad for a boy. Many times when somebody goes to a doctor, some doctors say, okay, don't have any fats, don't have any oils, your cholesterol is high, you have heart problem, you have this, you have that. Fine. But you cannot do without oils and without fats. Because it is very important for the functioning of our body, certain enzymes in our body, our tissues in the body need certain amount of fat. So 20 to 25% of our calories must come from fats. But you must choose the right type of fats. Not cheese, not butter, not having cakes, pastries, all this contain bad type of fats. We can use the vegetable oils. And we can eat fish instead of meats. The meats contain bad fats, whereas fish, especially the oily fish, that is the meat sometimes people say, mackerel, sardines, a lot of oil are not good. But that oil is a very good oil medicinally. So this type of fatty fish, our local fish, is very good. Shellfish, prawns are not good, but they are very high in cholesterol. So having fish as an alternative to meats is very good. Of course, in childhood, for players, for people who are very active, red meats are important. Because they burn out their whatever fats they eat with the activity that they do. But for us, when we reach this middle age and slight advanced age, it is better to have fish. Of course, fish is costly. So, I think Father Valerian will have to increase your subsistence for So, consuming the right fat, consuming the right oil is important. Another thing of very important note is, all our ancestors, now this I combine with another healthy form of exercise and activity, all our ancestors, they never ate saffola or olive oil or any of that type of oil. When we were children, we used to have coconut oil or we used to have groundnut oil, we used to call it wheaten oil. All these fancy oils were not available at that time. And I still remember people slaughtering the local pork, eating the skin which contains so much of fat. Feasting on pork, feasting on beef, eating merrily, and even having their kopache merrily, and not getting sick. They used to live right long ages. What is the difference today? The difference today is our activity has decreased. If we want to go from here to the Basilica, we will go on a scooter if not in the car. We won't go walking. Similarly, our youngsters today, if they have to go a short distance, they need a bike. And we make it a habit as parents to give their children a bike. We don't tax them. We don't send our children to play. They play on the computer. Children in school have mobiles. They play mobile games. They are on WhatsApp. They are on Facebook. Why they give away the time? Today, I run 40 football centers all over Goa, mostly in the villages. And what do I see? Our Catholic children take the least advantage. The migrant children, children of migrants, are the ones who take the most advantage of all the facilities given. Hindus are coming up. We are taking part in this. But our Catholic children are too threatened, even in the villages, that they don't come for attending the camps. They don't come for regular practice. And even if they join, there is feast, there is some wedding, there is some function, they are absent most of the time. So this is what is happening to our youth today. So we must make it a point to see that our youth take up this challenge of doing exercise. We have talented youth. We have a lot of youngsters when they are very young, they play very well. But as they grow up, they are outshone. Today you see the state of Goan football only. We have so many good football players who never received training in the past. They played barefoot in the fields. They played with hardly any good boots, but they became great footballers. Goa was shining. Today, we don't find Goa shining. We don't find good footballers because our youth are not getting the motivation and encouragement from their young age to go into it. Our families are just fattening the children, giving them mobiles, giving them bikes, giving them everything possible that they don't have to strive hard. Even in education sphere, you find migrants and Hindu children studying better than our Catholic children because there is no motivation for them, because they get to be. These migrants, they don't get anything, they have to prove a point. So they try hard, they work hard, they come up in a very good way. So I think we all are the messiahs of our state today, can do a lot and try and educate our parents and children, especially in our schools, to get into physical activity, which is very important. And we should do physical activity to keep ourselves fit. Most of the time, you find people saying, even priests who come to me, so many of them have come, they have no time for exercise. We are busy. There are yoginas, there are confessions, I will visit my parishioners, I will visit them. Fine, good. But keep a timetable. Keep just 45 minutes for yourself, only 45 minutes. Where you can go for a brisk walk. I know all of you may not be able to afford a private gym like our previous Archbishop used to have. His own gym. No, and he's doing regular exercise. He's still fit up till today. If you see, he's health-wise, he may have got a little degeneration of the top story. But otherwise, his body is fit. So, we do not have a private gym, all of us, but we can always go for a walk. 45 minute brisk walk, either early in the morning or in the evening, please make it a point. I am a very busy professional. I work from morning 8 o'clock till 1 o'clock at night. You will see what this man is saying, being a doctor, but I have my dinner only at 1:30 at night. I go sleep at 2:30, I get up at 7:30 in the morning, in between at night I have emergency calls. But I never miss my exercise 5 days a week. I close my clinic at 6 o'clock and I'm off for my either playing football or my jogging. I'm back in the clinic at 8 o'clock again to look after my patients till I finish even at midnight and past midnight. But I make my time. make time for yourselves to do this exercise, and it will really help you. Then enjoy plenty of fruits and vegetables. Very important are fruits and vegetables, which many of us miss. I know that many priests living in some villages have a problem for food. They don't have cooks, they don't have proper food coming to them. Pardon me for telling you all this, but I hope with God's grace you will get some good people who will prepare your good food. But please see that you buy some fruits, have fruits every day. It is said that you might have 5 portions of fruit and vegetable every day. Whether it is fruit or a fresh fruit juice, don't have these canned juices and preserved juices. Have fresh fruit juices if you can, or have fruits, have vegetables. They contain vitamins, they contain minerals, they have a lot of roughage in the diet. The Westerners were not having vegetables. They used to eat more of meats. And what happened to them? They started getting a lot of colonic cancers. Now you find many Westerners eating a lot of greens, salads, vegetables. So I think all of you must get on to fruits and vegetables. And that is very easy to have. You can buy your fruits, have them for breakfast, have them for lunch, have them as a mid-morning snack, have at night. It's very good for health. Now coming to sugar and salt. Sometimes people have the notion that I have pressure, I should not have any salt, which is wrong. Please don't avoid salt. We are a country which has got we are a state which has a lot of humidity. We sweat. We may not have sweat pouring on our temples and our body, but we have what we call as insensible perspiration, and we lose a lot of salt. So we need a normal salt intake. But avoid excess salt. Avoid foods that are salted, like salted nuts, salted biscuits, shumchuda, maybe salt fish, or chips, anything that is salted, or adding of table salt to make it more salty, the food that is served to you, please avoid. But have normal salt, unless some person has got a real medical problem which necessitates that you have no salt. There are some conditions like kidney failure or severe heart failure where you have to curb salt completely. But in normal circumstances and even in people with hypertension, please don't stop your salt. Have normal salt, but avoid excess salt. Sugar. Normally people who do not have diabetes can have sugar, but avoid soft drinks. Now that is the scourge of our youth and of our people today. They like to have soft drinks. They like to have colas. All this contains very bad substances and high amount of sugar, which is bad for health in all aspects. So you must promote having fresh juices rather than this type of soft drinks. Because Coca-Cola and other giants may try to shoot me if I am saying this. But from health point of view, I will tell you what is correct. All these edited beverages are not good for health. Once in a way, okay. But our youth today are getting addicted to it, and we keep on having these soft drinks on and on.
Excuse me, doctor.
Maybe just 3 minutes.
Yes.
And as far as the sugar is concerned, people who have diabetes have to keep off sugar completely. People who have a very sweet tooth may use the artificial sweeteners, only a tablet or two. Many people give a wrong notion that artificial sweeteners are bad for health, they cause cancer. But that is if you are having a large quantity. Some people use them to make cakes, to make puddings, to make sweets. That is bad. but just for a cup of tea or coffee, in case you need, put a tablet and have it. There is no health problem as far as that is concerned. And today, the labels on the food, as far as Food and Drug is concerned, administration, they see that labels are put on the food so that all the substances that you consume, you know what is there in it. How much protein, how much carbohydrates, how much sugar, added sugar, everything is written on it. Please eat regularly. Don't skip any meal. Especially some people have a tendency to skip breakfast and run here and there for their work. Don't skip your meals. It is better to eat small meals at regular intervals rather than to eat large meal at one time. Keep your stomach hungry for a long time. Get acidity problems and other digestive problems. Drink plenty of water. In our country, again, because of humidity in our state, you need plenty of fluids. Many of us don't have fluids. We develop kidney stones, kidney problems, and then we start crying. So before we do that, please see that we have water in between. Some people will have water in the morning and then they will have straight maybe in the evening or in the afternoon. In the middle time where the temperature is hot, you're running about, please try to have water. And don't carry water in those flimsy plastic bottles because plastic is bad for the pollution of the world. Plus, you get the plastic while exposed to heat coming into the water. You taste the water you're using. It tastes different. Use the thick glass bottles or thick plastic bottles to carry your water. Especially some people carry it in their cars. The cars get heated, the bottles get heated. So please be careful about that. And please get on the move, make it a habit. Use the stairs instead of the elevators. Go for a walk every day and see that you all make some weekend activity. When you have a weekend activity,